What's up guys, my name's RJ and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing a why I've decided to read A Pattern of Shadow and Light by Melissa McPhail. So this is a series I've heard about for a while. I think I heard about it at some point last year. I think it was one of the first videos I watched from Mike's book reviews. He did a video on female fantasy authors that he wanted to read, and I believe A Pattern of Shadow and Light was on that list. I've heard things about it. I'm going to go over why I've decided to read it, what I've heard about it so far, what it's about, at least the first book, and that's basically it. So, first of all, I think we should just go over basically what the book's about. And from what I've heard, it is quite a complex series. Like, it's up there with the complexity of, say, A Wheel of Time. You know, A Wheel of Time is a somewhat complex series, especially towards the end, from what I know. So, yeah, just going to go over what it's about. So, I'm just going to read from what it says on Amazon, because I feel like this is a good... I've looked at a few descriptions, and I think this is a good one. Or this is the best one. All things are composed of patterns, and within the patterns of the realm of Alerlin, three strands must cross. In Alerlin, 300 years after the genocidal Adept Wars, the realm is dying, and the blessed Adept race dies with it. One man holds the secret of reverting this decline, Bjorn von Gelderen, a dangerous and enigmatic man whose shocking betrayal 3 centuries past earned him a traitor's brand. It is the Adept Vestral Rien de la Croute's mission to learn what Bjorn knew in the hope of salvaging his race. But first, he'll have to find him. In the kingdom of Damin, the young prince Envan Lorien faces a tenuous future as the last living heir to the coveted Eagle Throne. Well, when his blood brother was slain during a failed assassination, Ian embarks on a desperate hunt for the man responsible. Yet his advisors have their own agendas, and his quest for vengeance leads him even deeper into a sinuous plot masterminded by the mysterious and powerful man, the one they call First Lord. In the Nadori Desert, tormented by the missing pieces of his life, a soldier named Trell heads off to uncover the truths of his shadowed past. But when disaster places him in the debt of the wildling sworn to the First Lord, Trell begins to suspect a deadlier, darker secret motivating them. So that's essentially what the first book, Sephiroth's Hand, is about. So I think the first question people will ask is it finished? It isn't finished. It is planned to be a 7-book series. There are currently 5 out, so Sephiroth's Hand being the first one. Book 2 is The Dagger of Edengeith? I don't know how to say that. Book 3 is The Path of Allir, book 4 being Kingdom Blades, and book 5 being The Sixth Strand. So, as I know, Melissa is writing books 6 and 7 together, so, and I believe she has book 6 written. So, I suspect we'll be getting the books not this year, but maybe next year, maybe in 2023. I think we'll at least see book 6. So we're not in a Gurm, we're not in a Pat Rothfuss situation, we're not in a Scott Lynch situation where we're waiting for the series to be finished. The series is being finished. So it may take a year or a couple of years, but we will eventually see the ending, I think. The reason why I'm reading this, I think, is because I was in my Wheel of Time high when I was reading this, or when I was reading, you know, I was reading Eye of the World and Grey Hunt. So I was sort of in this Wheel of Time high where this was, you know, a really good series. And then later on, it started to really decline for me, in especially book 5. So I've been wanting a series kind of like Wheel of Time, but not Wheel of Time, that doesn't get bogged down with the descriptions and stuff like that, you know, that doesn't really meander. I don't know if this series does that or not. Somebody can let me... You know, if any of you have read at least Sephiroth's Hand, or, you know, even the entire series, let me know if this is a problem. And again, These are also as well, these aren't short books. I believe all of them are at least 800 pages, usually about 800 to 1,000. So you're sort of average, you're slightly above average Wheel of Time books, I think these come in at. What else I've heard about is the magic system. The magic system is very similar to is very similar to Wheel of Time. That's where I think a lot of the Wheel of Time comparisons come from for this series. And again, it's also a series I haven't heard. There's not a lot of talk about it on YouTube. There are reviews of the first book, Zephyril's Hand, but there's not a lot after that. So I would really, if I like the series, I will be reviewing it and I will give attention to this because I do want to give attention to some of these lesser known fantasy series. I don't want to continuously talk about series like Wheel of Time or Stormlight Archive or, even series like First Law or stuff like that. I don't want to get or Malazan, there's plenty of other people that do that and do better content than me at that, but I do just want to give some of these lesser known series a go. And as well, I do want to read like female authors. This is a genre that tends to be male dominated, so I think giving some attention to some of the female authors who are just as good or even better, I'd like to give some attention to those. So yeah, so this was this is just me saying, well, I'm going to read this series. I'm going to read Sephiroth's Hand, I'd say in the next few weeks. I'm going to be reading, as soon as I finish up Dark Tower, I'm in the middle of Wolves of the Cala. I would like to get to this. I think this is a really good, I hope this will be a really good series for me because I've been looking at this series for, over a year, and I would be, really happy. Almost 2 years, maybe. Maybe it's closer to 2 years. I would love to finally get this series in. So, thank you guys for watching this. This is just a quick one. If you liked it, do all that stuff. You guys know what to do. And hopefully I'll see you guys in the next one. Slam.